Hello, everyone. Now, for those of you who do not know, I recently lost my father. And due to circumstances, I wasn't able to say anything at his funeral. And I cannot tell you how much that hurts, how devastating that was for me. So instead, I decided to do a memorial video for my dad on my channel. I really want people to know just how amazing he was, everything he did for me, and how much I appreciated him as my father. So, for the next, I'm not sure how long this is going to be, I'm going to break down who my dad was, how much he had done for me in my life, and how I grew up to be who I am because of him. So, without further ado, let's get started. Now, if you ever met my dad, you would know right away that he was from Georgia, because he had a very thick Georgian accent. Now, I won't tell you exactly where in Georgia, because he also had a knack for not wanting people to know, well, anything. So, I'm not going to tell you where in Georgia he was born, but just know he was from Georgia. He grew up on a family farm where I think he got his work ethic from, because that man was not afraid to work. In fact, he worked every day until the day he passed away. And he taught both me and my sisters that same work ethic. No matter what you were doing, Dad didn't care, as long as you were working hard at it. And we continue to do that moving on to this day. Now, he didn't spend all of his youth down in Georgia. In fact, once he got old enough, he started to explore. He went around everywhere. He went all through the states, Canada. He even spent a little time in Mexico, but he spent a good chunk of his youth out on the islands. In fact, he became a diver, a professional diver out there, doing all kinds of cool things that he even taught us when we were growing up. In fact, he took us to some of those islands that he spent time at when we were older, and it was really fun to learn exactly what he was doing all those years ago and being able to try some of it myself. Eventually, my dad moved back to the States and decided to prepare to settle down. Now, there's one thing I gotta tell you about my dad. He had style. I mean, that man knew how to wear a suit. I mean, just look at him in some of these suits. And in the evening when the sun goes down, it's never dark when she's around. Now that's style. Old school style. None of us young people can ever hope to pull that off. But I tried. I think I got close. But anyway, after a while, that style attracted a very smart, strong-willed woman that was my mom. And a little while after they met, they got married. And then, not too long after that, they had 4 happy accidents, and then actually got the kid they wanted, me. I mean, just look at that bundle of joy. No wonder they kept trying. In fact, I believe my mom said when I was born, "All right, I ain't having any more." I'm thinking that that means that I was just that perfect that she felt she didn't need to have any more kids. At least that's what I'm going with anyway. Now, growing up with my dad was interesting. There were definitely ups and there were downs. But just like I told you, he wanted us to be happy. He taught us how to work so that we could provide for ourselves one day. And you know what? I might not have appreciated that at a young age. I do appreciate it now. Now, it wasn't just all work. Dad also made sure we had plenty of play. He took us on a lot of trips, and he took us to one of our favorite pastimes, fishing. Me and my dad love fishing. My dad in particular. He was always fishing. He fished so much that it was like a normal thing to us. When people would say, "Oh, you guys went fishing," we were like, "Yeah." And like, we always go fishing because that was one of his favorite pastimes. Going fishing and going fishing with his kids. Now, another cool thing about my dad is that he did not care what other people had to say or what they thought about him. Now, this doesn't mean that he wouldn't, you know, be a good friend to people or, you know, not listen to people. No. Everyone kind of had a certain level with him. Like, if you were his friend, he'd be there for you no matter what. He'd have your back. He'd be there for you with advice. If you needed help, he was there. He was 100% there. But if you were overstepping your bounds as anyone, as a friend or a brother, it doesn't matter. Once you got to that point, he let you know you got to that point. He let you know that he was not going to let that affect him. I am so proud that I was his son because I picked that up too. And at certain points, I am so happy I did. Because I went through a lot of hard times. And although my dad was with me, I am happy that I could sit back and go, you know what? I don't care what this person thinks. This is what I want to do. This is what makes me happy. So I'm going to do it. And my dad was right there with me the whole entire time. That was my dad. That's how he treated everyone around him. If you treated him good, he treated you good. If you treated him bad, he was done with you. And that's how it should be, I believe. Now, although Dad stood his ground when he needed to, that doesn't mean that he wasn't a friendly guy. My dad made friends everywhere he went, with anybody. He didn't care what race you were, what color you were, or where you were from. As long as you were a cool person, he was willing to sit down and have a laugh with you. And man, did he love to laugh. He would constantly make up jokes or crazy, stupid things just to get you going. I remember watching him and my mom, and mom not knocking him out so many times, and me being amazed because he really knew how to push that woman's buttons. But then again, he could figure out how to push anybody's buttons. But it was amazing. Right after you'd be mad at him, not minutes later, you'd be sitting there just happy that you're sitting and talking and hanging out with him. He just had that ability with people, and I'm glad I got a little bit of that too. I love talking to people as well. I love making friends, and I love hanging out with people. And I'm glad that I got that from my dad. Because of that, I know that I can keep making friends and meeting good people as long as I treat them right, just like dad. Lastly, my dad was a protector. Not just physically, mentally, he was ready to protect. He was not afraid to take a hit if it meant we wouldn't suffer. He was not afraid to face something horrible on his own if it meant we wouldn't get hurt. When my dad passed, he called me first, a little bit before he died, from the hospital bed, knowing that I was worried sick about him and not able to see him because of COVID. He called me, making sure I knew he was all right. A little bit after that, I got a call that I lost my father. Even in his dying moments, he was more concerned about his family than he was himself. That was my dad. And I cannot tell you how proud I am to be his son. How proud I am to have his name. So much so that this video isn't enough. It's not enough. So instead, I also decided to build something for my dad. Dad was proud of my YouTube channel. He's proud of what I was able to do with something I love. So I merged the two. I created a memorial park for my dad on my private server. This is Big Chuck National Park. My dad's name was Chuck, and I am Baby Chuck. Therefore, I named this park after him. Everything in this park has to do with my relationship with my dad. There are all fishing spots, some of our favorite places to go and fish together. So I recreated them here, right next to my home base on my personal server that I plan to never leave. That's how much my dad meant to me. That's how much I'm going to miss him. Before I go, I just want to say thank you to all of my subscribers who have been sending awesome messages, as well as my YouTube friends like The Magical Berry, The Redstone Scientist, and Hero Academy Gaming. You guys' warm messages have truly helped me as, you know, I get through this. And every step, every day, I get a little better. I still have a long road ahead of me, so I appreciate you guys taking the time to watch this video, helping me say goodbye to one of the greatest men I'll ever know. Thank you.